let's talk about professional volleyball players. You see, they're kind of like the rest of us, except they're really, really, really good at volleyball. Like, what I mean by that is they're able to pull off volleyball skills that I didn't even think were possible. I have had the opportunity to travel all around the world and watch the Volleyball Nations League this year. And if you don't know what that is, it is a 7-week long volleyball tournament where the top men's and women's volleyball teams all compete against each other. I've had the opportunity to watch so much good volleyball in the past month. What we are going to do today is react to some of the top Volleyball Nations League highlight plays. All of these plays come from the leg of the tournament that just happened here in Ottawa, Japan. It's going to be a ton of fun. I'm super excited. If you want to catch all of the Volleyball Nations League action this summer for yourself, make sure to go to vb.tv and use code PME10 for 10% off your subscription. This will give you access to every single Volleyball Nations League game this summer. And I'll tell you that the games that I haven't been able to watch in person, I've been streaming myself on vb.tv. So highly recommend you go check that out. Remember, use code PME10 for 10% off your vb.tv subscription. Let's get right into the highlight plays. First up, we have Team USA versus Argentina. Match point for Team USA. This is a match that I was actually able to attend in person. Team USA starts off the rally with two blocks in a row. Argentina is scrambling to get the volleyball over. Team USA has a free ball opportunity. They go to DeFalco on the outside, and he pummels it for game point. Team USA versus Argentina. Team USA beats Argentina in a 3-0 sweep. Ooh, what a way to start off the video with America, the homeland, representing. TJ DeFalco is one of the most electric outside hitters in the volleyball world right now, and he honestly plays the game of volleyball like he just does not have a care in the world. It's the greatest thing to watch, honestly. He'll do things that you didn't even think were possible, and he'll just make it look easy. The guy is just an absolute menace to society. So fun to watch. Let's give that play an 8.5 out of 10 to start off the video. That's like the perfect way to end a volleyball match too. Well done, Mr. DeFalco. Well done. Next up, we have Cuba versus Canada. Cuba goes to the big ball, and that ball is destroyed. Somebody go check the floor on the other side of the court, because I think there might be a dent in it. At the two men's volleyball legs that I've been at on my trip, I've been to two women's and two men's. To give you a little backstory on the nation of Cuba, currently they are competing in the VNLs in hopes of securing a spot at the Olympics later this summer. There's only a handful of nations out there that have secured their bids to the Olympic tournament. So what you'll see is teams like Cuba are still trying to compete their way into getting a spot. I think they've been using that as a chip on their shoulder as they've been competing in the VNLs this summer. Because not only is it every nation's dream of hosting an Olympic medal, it's an honor in itself to even make the Olympics. So shout out to Cuba. I'd love to see you guys compete in Paris this summer. Side rants aside, part of the reason they even have a chance to compete for an Olympic spot this year is because they're doing stuff like that. That ball was hit from a stratosphere that I'm actually unfamiliar with. I don't really know the feeling of jumping that high or hitting that hard. So I guess the next best thing that I have going for me is watching Cuba do it. That's a solid 8 out of 10 for me. Up next, we have another Canada-Cuba highlight play. Cuba shanks the serve receive ball, so they're kind of scrambling to get it over the net, and Canada comes in with the stuff to win the game 3-1. What an electric play, and they have their home fans backing them as these matches are happening in Ottawa, Canada. So that's awesome for Canada to pull out a victory on their home turf. And they did it in a considerably fashionable style, as the great block of O Canada was too big for the Cubans to handle, and that ball went straight down into court. Let's give that play a solid 7 out of 10. We got Team USA versus Italy here. Italy comes in with the jump serve. That ball is ripped. Team USA has to settle for a high out of system set to the outside. Picked up by Italy, but they got to do an out of system set of their own and a sneaky little dump over the net by the outside to win the set, and the Italians are dancing. You love to see it. If you're an Italy fan, hate to see it if you're a USA fan. And because I am a USA fan, I hate to see it. One thing that we absolutely have to highlight about that play is that Alessandro Michelialetto, I completely butchered that. I'm so sorry. I apologize. The outside hitter number 5 for Italy, the guy who served the ball, he's one of the best volleyball players on planet Earth right now. I mean, guys, just listen to this. He is a 6'9" lefty outside hitter. What on earth is Italy putting in their water to make their volleyball players come out with genetics like that? So yeah, when you take those measurables and you combine them with a ton of volleyball skill, you get Alessandro Michelialetto. Miki Alleto. I think that is the closest I will get. Miki Alleto. Yeah, absolute baller. Besides that, the highlighting play wasn't really highlighting for me. My favorite part of it was the Italians doing their little dancey dance after they won the set. But besides that, the actual play itself wasn't the greatest. Let's give that a 3 out of 10. Moving on. To start off our next highlight play, Argentina is serving on match point. Canada goes to the outside, but it is tipped. Argentina has a chance to go on offense with a free ball. They tip it over from the back row. Canada is scrambling, but they managed to give Argentina another free ball chance. Where is Argentina gonna go? Straight to the middle. That game is put away by the Argentinian squad to give them victory in Ottawa, Canada. I will say personally, DiCecco, I probably butchered that last name as well. The Argentinian setter is one of my favorite volleyball players to watch. He's so creative and so crafty with every single set he does, and he keeps the other team's blockers guessing constantly. That was a great choice and set to the middle to put away the game for Argentina and give them the victory. Let's give that play a solid 6 out of 10. Here we have Cuba versus Italy. Gianelli, he can do no wrong on offense except for when he sets the middle and it gets absolutely housed by Cuba. Dang. If I haven't said this before, Simone Gianelli is my favorite volleyball player of all time. He's a setter for the nation of Italy, and I just absolutely love watching that guy set. He's truly perfected the setting craft and the art of being an offensive setter, which are both things that I try and copy in my own game. So while I thought we might get a sick Gianelli setting highlight, instead we got a Cuba monster block, which I'm not mad about whatsoever. That's definitely a solid 7 out of 10 block for me. We have another highlight from the Italy-Cuba game. Italy does have match point in this situation. Cuba is down in quite a big hole in the fourth set here. Gianelli goes to the opposite and that ball is ripped cross court to give Italy the win and make up for that monster block highlight that we just had to react to a minute ago. I am a setter, so it's only right that I glazed the crap out of that set, because that back set to the D ball on the opposite was absolutely beautiful by Gianelli. And of course, the opposite did his job and hit the ball really, really, really hard. In fact, a little too hard for the Cuba defense to handle, and they score and win the game. That is an 8 out of 10 because I love seeing Gianelli set. Hey, I might be super biased and have really weird criteria that I rank these volleyball highlights with, but it's a PME volleyball video. I'm allowed to do that. Let's move on. Up next, we have a France versus Netherlands match highlight. What is gonna happen here? We have a D ball to the opposite and boom, that ball is absolutely destroyed, hammered, mollywopped, clobbered, walloped, whatever adjective you wanna use to describe that volleyball highlight, please feel free to do so, because my word, was that ball hit hard. One fact about the France volleyball national team is that they are deep. I swear the depth of that country runs so deep that you could have an A, a B, and a C team, send them all to a national tournament and they would all do well. Maybe that's a tad bit of an exaggeration, but you can kind of see what I'm getting at. They're ridiculously good at volleyball, although I feel that that play in particular wasn't the craziest of highlight plays, so let's give it a 5 out of 10. Ooh, another France-Netherlands highlight. We have what looks like a middle run that is absolutely hammered. That is what I like to see. Let me just quickly illustrate what I saw in simplistic terms. The ball was passed a little tight to the net, but the setter reached up, did something super acrobatic to bring it back to their side, and he gave it to their middle, and the middle said bet, and boomed that volleyball almost 10-foot line. That play was nutty. 8.5 out of 10. We have another Netherlands-France highlight. What's gonna happen in this one? We have a big ball that is hit into the deep right corner, giving France another exciting electric volleyball point. One of my favorite things that I've seen in the VNLs this summer is that almost every time an outside hitter gets a kill out of the back row, what they'll do is this. They'll land after hitting the ball, and given they'll land pretty close to the volleyball net, and then they'll just like walk under the net just like that. And yeah, I don't know. There's just something about that that never fails to amuse me. So because I got to see that in the highlight play, we'll give it a 7 out of 10. Okay, up next, we have a USA versus Serbia match highlight. I wonder if this is gonna be USA or Serbia highlight. And yep, that is a USA highlight, as that ball to the outside is obliterated into the backcourt and sent into Narnia. Honestly, one of my favorite things about that play was the Eric Shoji serve receipt pass. He kind of did like a little drive-by as he was like walking by, he boom, passed it perfectly. He passed it perfectly to Micah Christensen, who delivered a strike to our outside hitter, and the rest was history. That's a solid 7.5 out of 10 for me. Looks like we have another USA versus Serbia match highlight. USA is serving the volleyball to Serbia. Let's see what happens with it. set to the outside and denied by Matt Anderson, who blocks that volleyball straight down. Between Matt Anderson, Micah Christensen, Eric Shoji, and TJ DeFalco, the core that Team USA has for their volleyball team is so good, man. And because they're so good, it makes them super entertaining to watch and gives us great moments like that. That's a great block, Mr. Anderson. I'm gonna give you a 7 out of 10. Ooh, up next we have France versus Cuba in the fifth set with Cuba having the lead. They have to do an out-of-system set to the outside for game point, and they pull off the upset as Cuba beats the nation of France in 5 sets. Holy smokes. I'm not gonna lie to you. I've been in Canada this entire time, and I had no idea that that happened. Yeah, wow, that's huge for the nation of Cuba. I know we touched on it earlier, but they are trying to make it into the Olympics this year, and that's a great win. That gets them 1 step closer to achieving that goal. Wow, well done, Cuba. You get an 8.5 out of 10 for beating France in 5 sets. Not a lot of people can say that done that. We got some Team USA versus Canada here for this next play. Canada goes to their middle, but Max Holt says, no, no, get that out of here, and gets the one-on-one solo stuff. There's no better feeling as a middle than winning a one-on-one blocking matchup against the middle of the other team. At least, I think that to be true. I've never played middle, so actually, I don't know. But it's gotta be so rewarding to get the best of the player opposite of the other side of the net. And for that block, I have to give it a 7 out of 10. Looks like Canada has set point here in this next clip. What is going to happen? Overpass by Team USA in serve receive. They go to the back row and that ball is destroyed, and the Canadian home fans are going crazy as they beat Team USA in set 3 of this matchup. If you guys don't know, Canada goes on to winning that match in 4 sets, which marks the first time in 5 years that Canada has beaten the United States of America in a VNL match. It was definitely a historic match for Canada. And as your downstairs neighbor, a content creator who lives in the United States of America, I say to you Canadians, well done. But I'm gonna give that highlight play a 5 out of 10 because I am a little sad that you beat us. We got Serbia and Argentina up next here. They are in extra points in set 1. What's gonna happen? Serbia goes to the D ball, but it is blocked but kept alive by Serbia. They send the ball over the net. Argentina has a chance to put it away, but it's blocked by Serbia, sent back over the net. Serbia now has a chance to put the ball away, but it's blocked for the 3rd straight block in a row. What the heck did I just watch? I just watched a block party, a big old block fest. Everybody was blocking each other. I don't think I've ever quite seen a play like that where 3 consecutive blocks happened in a row. That was madness. That was super impressive. An easy 8.5 out of 10. Looks like we got Italy versus the Netherlands up next here. Netherlands on offense. They go to their opposite, who puts that ball down hard as a meteor in the middle of the volleyball court, giving the Netherlands the point. If I didn't know any better, I thought that that ball might have been launched from outer space. But no, it came from the right hand of Namir Abdul Aziz, who I definitely butchered his name. I've butchered the names of so many pro volleyball players in this video. I'm so sorry to any of you if you're watching this. I'm pretty sure you're not. But yeah, let's just say he's really good at what he does. That's a 9 out of 10 for me. I think that's one of the hardest hit balls we've seen so far. We have Italy versus the Netherlands here to end the video. Netherlands go to their outside hitter, but the Italian libero makes an insane dig at a system set. Hi to Miki Aleto. He's blocked off of his shoulder, but the libero makes a great set off of the blocked ball that hit Miki Aleto's shoulder, and he just goes up and hits the ball with his left hand, which might as well be a cannon, to give Italy the point in a crazy volleyball rally. Wow, I hope I did a good job commentating what just happened. But yeah, that's an absolutely electric play to end the video off on. Miki Aleto, the outside hitter from Italy, just doing Miki Aleto things. And those things can just be described as magical. I mean, really, that's what he's doing at the core. He's pulling off magic. That is a 10 out of 10 PME volleyball highlight play right there to end off the highlight reaction video. Wow, what a rally. And that concludes the Volleyball Nations League highlight plays that happened here in Ottawa, Canada. I again want to thank my friends over at Volleyball World for giving me an opportunity to be here and watch all of the VNL matches. Again, make sure to go check out VB.TV and create yourself a subscription using code PME10 to get 10% off and catch all of the VNL games that are remaining this summer. We are getting into the playoffs, super exciting stuff. I highly recommend you check it out. If you guys want to see some more reaction videos, let's hit 1,000 likes on this video and I will catch you guys in the next one. PME Volleyball's out. Go out there and play some volleyball. See you in the next video. Peace.